picture this. 30 years ago, it's a true story. In West Africa, Cameroon, there is a valley. And from one night to the other, all life is wiped out. So on the valley floor, there are over 2,000 people laying dead, but also all the animals. And there is no trace of destruction. And back then, 30 years ago, I was a student and I watched the evening news. And there was just one picture. It showed dead cows. And the anchor woman said, well, we don't know what happened. And this ever stayed in my mind. And actually, I went there to do a radio report. I was young, I had a microphone, I went to the Death Valley. And I spoke to priests and scientists and survivors and the local king. And in the end, they couldn't explain what happened. It was still a mystery. And for the book, La Vallée Tueuse, I've been back. And it was a different question. It's not the question, what happened, but what do people tell that happened? So it's a story about a story. It's a story, a true story about interpretation, fiction, legends, and the birth of myth. Yes, what I tried to do, I did a step back and looked at the Death Valley, which is still off limits. It's still guarded by the military. And the mystery is still intact. Of course, there are scientific explanations, but there are different ones. So it depends on the scientist you talk to, what kind of explanation you get. So the mystery is still there, even 30 years after it happened. And then I thought, like, look, doesn't this look like almost a natural laboratory for how do new stories emerge? And this is what I try to do. I try to look at the Death Valley as a testing ground to see the forest of stories that have grown from scratch. And you get old stories mingled with new ones. A very popular one at the moment is that France or the United States had planted a bomb and they wanted to test the effects. And people tell you, look, the scientists are still coming. Isn't this suspicious? What are they doing? Even 25, 30 years after it happened, they're still measuring what? The fallout or the after effects of it, of their testing. So you have, I think that complot theories are modern day myth. It is mind blowing. The fact that after 30 years, the scientific community hasn't come up with a single undisputed explanation, that's part of the miracle. And here comes in also room for magic, room for poetry, room for all kinds of other explanations. And I speak about killers of myth, people that say there is no devil, there is no ghost, there is nothing supernatural about it. You have the bringers of myth, the priests that try to console the people by telling biblical stories. And you have the myth makers. And I think it is our condition, we are all, whether we're African or not, we're all myth makers. That's what, when it comes in, when we don't understand something completely, what we don't understand, we fill up with stories or metaphors. Yes, as a writer, of course, I'm retelling this story again. And once you retell a story, it's like multiplying an existing story. And I think this is the way stories grow. And you can compare it with evolution. Stories also evolve, they mutate. And this is the thing I wanted to investigate. I wanted to put my finger on the birth of stories and how they grow. Maybe 25, 30 years is still early days, but I think you can come closest to the birth of a new myth in the Death Valley of Cameroon.